Hello, in this video I will show you how to install SAP GUI for Java. SAP GUI for Java can be installed in many operating systems, like it can be installed in Windows, Solaris, Mac, Linux and AX. Okay, in this video I am going to show you how to install this particular software in Windows operating system. I am using Windows 7 operating system. Okay. And this is the file I need to use for installing SAP GUI for Java. Okay, there are three types of GUI softwares are available for accessing SAP systems. They are SAP GUI for Windows, SAP GUI for Java and SAP GUI for HTML. If you want to learn more about this particular GUI software, you can go back and there you can find out the documentation here. Just open it and read about all types of GUI versions. So these are all the GUI versions: SAP GUI for Windows, SAP GUI for HTML, SAP GUI for Java. Okay, just go back and open GUI folder. Under GUI folder there is a Java, and under Java this is the file. Just double click on that particular file. Okay, so that SAP GUI for Java installation will be started. SAP GUI for the Java environment installation, welcome, and click next here. Okay, it will be installed within SAP clients folder. Click OK. Installation has completed successfully. Corresponding log file can be found here. Click OK. Just directly go to the RAS folder. Under RAS folder there is a SAP clients folder. So these are all the folders will be installed. Okay, you can also access this particular program from all programs, SAP clients, and there is a SAP GUI for Java. Click on it so that SAP GUI for Java environment will be opened. Okay, so right now there are no connections available. You need to create the connection. Before creating connection, you should have the values of your SAP system. Okay, let us see the SAP system. This is SAP system NW7EHP1. So actual server name is NW7EHP1. The system number is 00. 00 means the port number is 3200. So that you can use these two values to create connection in the SAP GUI for Java. Just click on create button here and go to advanced and select expert mode and name your connection as NetWeaver 7.0 EHP1, and after connection con equal to slash h means host name slash again, and host name is NW7EHP1 slash again s is the port number 3200. If your system number is something around something like 01, you need to use 3201. If your system number is 02, then you need to use 3202. Okay, in our case it is 00, that's why I have used 3200. Click on save button here. Once it is saved, you can access your SAP system using SAP GUI for Java. Just double click on this particular connection to connect to the SAP system like this. Okay, the look and feel also little bit different from the SAP GUI for Windows. So let us open SAP GUI for Windows also, just to see the difference between that and this. Okay, where is that SAP GUI for Windows? This is SAP GUI for Windows. Okay, you just see SAP GUI for Windows. Okay, so this is the entry, you need to open, double click on it. So we are connecting to the same system using different GUIs. See, this is SAP GUI for Java and this is SAP GUI for Windows. So there is a difference between this and this, and from here there is a question mark. You can find out the version of your SAP GUI for Java environment, that is SAP GUI for Java 7.20 so and so. Okay, in the same way you can find out the information about this particular thing also by after logging inside. Okay, so I am using SAP user here. to log into the system. Here I am using DDIC. Okay, we are actually connecting to the same system using different GUI softwares, that is SAP GUI for Java and SAP GUI for Windows. Okay, this is SAP NetViewer, SAP GUI for Windows. The version is this. Version is 7200.1.0.3245. Okay, so in this way you need to install SAP GUI for Java. I hope you understood how to install SAP GUI for Java and you have seen the difference between SAP GUI for Java and SAP GUI for Windows. So thanks for watching. That's all. And in next video I will show you how to install, how to access SAP system using SAP GUI for HTML. That is another way of accessing SAP system. So let's meet in next video. Thanks for watching.